Owing that to freedom, depends on continued decentralization and then, besides reasonable for people to want to be continually reassured not only that our vaccines are safe and effective, but also we have the supply that we need. So I want to request both points today, especially in light of concern you and may have heard in some other countries by the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. First, the Independent Medicines and Healthcare Collaborative Regulatory Agency has reviewed the evidence, as it does every week. They've confirmed the benefits of the vaccine in preventing COVID far outweigh any risks, and people should continue to get their vaccine when asked to do so. During more safe, a little bit more about that in a moment. It's also very important for our European friends that today the European Medicines Agency has come to a clear scientific conclusion by, quote, "This is a safe and effective vaccine." We also saw yesterday the evidence from Public Health England that a single dose of either vaccine provides 60% protection against daily COVID and reduces the chances of hospitalization by 80% and risk of death by 85%. So the Oxford jab is safe and the Pfizer jab is safe. The thing that isn't safe is batching COVID, which is why it's so important that before the RBIs, Muslims are governed, as it happens, I'm giving my lawyer at the centre, where I'm doing a jab is currently using the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. Those receiving the first dose of that is the one I'll be on. And let me also assure you, if you come from it after receiving your letter, we have the jabs for you. We've always said that in a vaccination program of this base and this scale, some interruptions in supply are inevitable, and it is true that in the short term, we're receiving fewer vaccines than we require for the difficulty, and that is because of a delay in a shipment from the Serum Institute that would be a part of the approval of producing vaccines in such large quantities. But because of the batch that we currently have in the UK, it needs to be retested with more rigorous safety programs. And as a result, we will receive slightly fewer vaccines in April than in March, but that is no more than we received in February. And the supply we do have will still enable us to hit the targets we have set. That means by 15th